Ja, I'm Matthias Betz. I'm a Senior Product Manager at VIFM Solutions. And today I want to present you a conceptual approach of how to integrate an existing edge software product, which is already under development for, I guess, 2 years now, introduced to the market a couple of months ago, and we discovered.
Let's go.
How can hear myself? So I make it a little reduced and speak a bit on my side. So what? We discovered that GenEdge.io is probably a good foundation for an existing edge software product. And what it means. I try to elaborate a bit today. So, what is Moneo Edge Connect? Is the name of the Edge software product. What is it all about? So, it's for sure an edge software that provides connectivity to several data sources in the field. So, IFM is maybe well known as an provider and vendor of sensors and components for industrial communication, and also for PLCs for particular use cases and contexts. And this is the main and the core feature of the product, and also has some edge computing capabilities like a no-code environment to create user-defined data flow models, to create new values based on the raw values coming from the data sources in the field for information information generation and pre-processing. And we're also currently developing with a new acquired data science company, which is already part of the IFM group now, more sophisticated features like predictions, pattern recognitions, and smart limits. But it also provides for particular devices, like we have a really robust industry-grade display. It also provides information and possibilities for interaction in the field. To display events, alarms, warnings, and also enable the user to interact in the context where the data is generated and acquired, and to provide annotations, confirmations, to reset counters, and so on. So it also have an interactive part. And last but not least, the third aspect or the third core concept is to provide also a remote access possibility to use the Edge Gateway to not only provide access to the Edge instance itself, but also to provide access to connected subsystems for troubleshooting, parameterization, configuration, and maintenance in general. So that's the core concept. The software is run currently on a variety of devices. On the left side and here in the middle, we see typical IFM edge devices. So this is the touch display, IP65 field device. It has a computing module, which is roughly comparable with the Raspberry Pi 4. There's also an IP20 variant of the same computing platform for the DIN rail in the cabin. But we also provide more scalable solutions like this little IPC here, which is also an image for exemplary illustration. So there are a couple of variants to run the software also on bigger platforms. And of course, we also have lots of smart devices in the pipeline and already on the market that may also be a platform for GenEdge.io. In terms of much smaller devices and field devices, but we decided to start with these typical edge devices we provide and have on the market currently. And then when we get familiar with the concepts and have the team up and running, then go further with smaller devices, which is usually a much bigger challenge. So, what are the current features? I already said that we have some inbound connectivity for I/O link masters, in particular the IFM I/O link masters, but also smart devices for vibration analysis, which is the VSE for particular use cases. Well, the VSE actually just consumes four data from coming from four sensors, 40,000 values per second each, and reduces it to mechanical KPIs to get an idea of what's going on with the mechanical rotating equipment in general. And it also has a remote access client. I already told that we have this data flow modeling thing. Maybe more important here is the outbound connectivity. We already provide an MQTT client that enables the user to pick and choose particular data sources and data streams and publish messages on a given broker. But we also have already included these four cloud connectors to enable the user to onboard the edge device to those particular cloud platforms and do the connection there. So here some screenshots how it is designed. So it's mainly focused on simplicity to enable and empower the OT workers to participate in IIoT projects, to make the onboarding of data sources from the field really simple. And then we call it plug and work, as with reference to the plug and play we already had in the IT world. And it's basically a couple of simple steps you have to provide. You just configure some target systems, as I already described, these cloud platforms or an existing MQTT broker. Then you go to the data sources, scan the network if the devices support a particular device discovery standard, or you just enter an IP address or something. And then we use drivers. We have a couple of drivers to connect to those devices, read out the metadata, and also subscribe to the provided data streams coming from the devices. In the next step, you just the Moneo Edge Connect creates an topology of connected devices, which represents the wiring and so on. And then you can just, as you see here, in these different columns, you can provide those data streams to cockpit, to an MQTT broker, or to the Cumulocity IoT platform here in this case, and just route the data from the source to the target. On the way, here on the right side, you see the possibility to have a really lightweight, no-code environment to do some pre-processing, logic, arithmetics, and conversations, conversions here with the provided data streams to create new information based on the input. And last but not least, you can create some interactive elements to use the display. And it's maybe not that relevant in case of headless devices. So, what I really want to talk about today is the question. So if we take this existing software and we want to leverage from all the advantages that and all the obvious advantages that Lineage provides, we have to think about how to use the existing, so to speak, architecture presented here in that build, in that picture to use the existing software, place it in that architecture, and use as much of the existing features to some extent create a kind of an abstraction layer that is lightweight, does not consume too much resources on the existing device, but provides some significant advantages to the existing solution. And what we have here in mind, especially, is the question of how to leverage from the device management and monitoring agent, which is still a gap in the existing product. So we started to conceptualize how to bring these two approaches together. So as a first step, I just want to show you that we consider ourselves the Monoway Edge Connect software as an other component in that case that provides some capabilities like connectivity to IO-Link devices, these vibration diagnostic units, PLC sensors, and whatsoever in the OT level. It is a commercial software product. It has some benefits. It's really user-friendly and has a simple UX design. And it actually has already the capability to connect to Cumulocity, Azure, Google, and AWS. But we want to transform that and use the NHIO platform to provide an abstraction underlying layer to leverage from the advantages of the NHIO framework. So as a first step, we are thinking about using the existing MQTT client to not publish to some broker, but to the local broker provided by Thin.io. Then we just publish there the acquired data that comes from the drivers and from the field devices, and also provide a mapper to convert that IFM IoT core format, that's how we call it internally, and convert it to the ThinEdge IO format, and then send the process data to the Cumulocity IoT platform as a first step. But we also want to leverage from the device management capabilities. So it's for us as we have already a strong relationship and a partnership with Software AG, it's also for us a good place to collaborate and to try out the device management functionality and implement that via this channel on and using ThinEdge.io to use the Cumulocity IoT to manage an Monoway Edge Connect instance. And of course, we are also already have an on-premise software, and we want to transform this software to the cloud. This is mainly planned for the next year. It's already an ongoing process. We are currently at least considering to use this mechanism also for the Monoway software as a service, which we currently call the Monoway Cloud. And as you may already see, there are some double things already existing here and also under development here in the ThinEdge.io world. So as a final step, we may contribute or we may switch from our own implementations to the ThinEdge.io implementations and contribute here as well, of course, and maybe someday in the future also at least support the integration of Google Cloud connectivity or AWS. So this is also something we are thinking of, but this is more a long-term idea. These are our first conceptual steps. Maybe to sum this all up, so we're currently focusing on two main aspects or areas of concern. So there are some organizational aspects. So Thin Edge IO is 4F and definitely a very promising approach, not only for small edge instances. So we start with the bigger instances and use it as a foundation or framework. We already committed to contribute with at least two FTEs. We are still in a conceptual phase, and we really faced the challenge of hiring Rust developers in the last couple of months. But we were to some extent successful, and we will actively contribute from the beginning of 2022. So this is good news. And the main aspects for IFM, as I already said, is the handling of the huge variety of OT devices and data sources. So therefore, the data mapping to transfer this heterogeneous world of the OT in terms of semantics into a common ThinEdge IO model is a central key aspect. We are also highlighting the security aspects of Rust, and we see this also as a key success factor for ThinEdge IO. And last but not least, for us, really from a strategic point of view for our products, and really important aspect is the device management agent, not only for the edge itself, but also for the underlying connected devices. But as I already said, step by step, so we're really, really looking forward to work more closer together with our colleagues from Software AG and hopefully many others that will join the community in the near future to create here and really promising edge approach for not only for free, but maybe also as a good foundation for commercial products. The way we see the ThinEdge IO. That's from my side. Some few comments on our conceptual considerations, I was really lucky to see also this kind of spirit of prototyping that is currently in the community. Maybe we can also create with the existing features of Edge Connect a kind of a prototype based on the approach that Rina presented. So maybe Rina, I will probably connect you afterwards to share the experience with Node-RED you made, and maybe we can already create a prototype pretty soon to connect Moneo Edge Connect with ThinEdge IO. So thank you very much for your attention, and back to Phil.